No, I had absolutely no clue. I think that's what kind of went into the whole crying aspect that we were all shocked. I mean, not necessarily at the ability. We all knew the ability and the talent for me was there to be a number one overall pick, but it was more about just the talk. You know, you hear the rumors of, oh, Twins need a pitcher and this and that, and it looks like they're going with Brendan McKay or Hunter Green. And so, you know, I would have been happy if it was Hunter. I was just hoping it was Hunter over Brennan, just because personally I knew him. You know, I didn't, I had no hard feelings against Brendan McKay at all. It was just more of a like, hey, that's my buddy. I hope he goes first, you know, whatever. But no, I personally had really good talks with San Diego, and the Padres, and they had number three, and I thought that was the highest I could possibly have gone. I had no, absolutely zero talks with the Reds organization. So I just they must not have liked what they saw in me or something. I don't know. But yeah, I thought Padres was the highest, and then maybe Braves. Those are two teams that really I was in heavy talks with a lot. I had probably more than three meetings with both of those teams and the Twins also. But I didn't get the sense that the Twins were going to pick me just because they were first. I don't know. I don't know if it, like some of my friends say, like, man, you're too humble. Maybe you just thought you didn't think you're like that highly of yourself. And I was like, no. For me, it was just more of like I truly thought they're going with a pitcher, and that's all I hear. And as the draft came closer, then they added my name into the list, and I was like, oh, this is a little crazy. Still didn't believe it. And then I got a call from my agency, and Scott Boras, and he said, you know, hey, make sure you bring a winter coat. He said, a warm coat. And I said, what? A warm winter coat? Is Atlanta cold? Is Atlanta cold? San Diego? What is he talking about? We're like, Tampa's definitely not cold. I know Florida's hot, so it wasn't them. And we started eliminating it. By the time we even thought about it, my cousin was like, hey, I'm hungry. Can we eat dinner while we're watching? Because we thought, you know, we might have to be waiting a little while. You know, it takes about 5 minutes in between picks and all that stuff. So we thought, all right, it might be a long time. My grandma was like, no, not until Royce gets picked and we get to watch all of his friends. We can eat and watch his friend, the rest of his friends get picked. And so, because we held it at their house, my grandparents' house. And so she told my cousin, no, basically, we have to wait till you get picked. And so he was all excited just because once I got picked, he's like, now we can eat. Like, yes, we can eat. So there's like so many little underlying things that were just hilarious that everyone was like either shocked or just excited about it in different ways. And I was just glad to have my whole family there and friends to be involved in that and to have that all on video so I can still watch it to this day. It's one of those things that you'll remember for the rest of your life.